All right, guys, welcome to the next lesson. So in this video, it's going to be short. I'm just going to talk to you about the three things you need to really move forward. So let's just call this section business and legal. And you need three things, guys. You need to incorporate. You need a U.S. bank account. You need a U.S. physical address. And so just to touch on that real quick, to incorporate, there's different forms of corporations. There's an actual corporation. There's a S Corp, there's an LLC. I'm not an attorney, guys. Just what I've done in the past is I've always structured my companies as an LLC. That's just my preference, which stands for Limited Liability Corporation. And the best approach really is dependent on how you want to structure. So when it comes to this, do you need an attorney? No, but should you get one, at least like consult with one? Yes. You can also search online to get some feedback on articles and look for yourself. So a form of corporation, probably for me, I do LLCs. I usually do like an S Corp because when you do an S Corp, it just means like when you file taxes, it goes through your personal. But everybody's different, guys. So form a corporation, set up your US bank account, and set up a physical address. Here's what I use, and you guys are welcome to use this as well. If you're international, this would work for you. If you're local in the States, this would work for you too. So it's called Buffalo Registered Agents. So you guys see the URL here? Go ahead and write it down. WY, which stands for the abbreviation of Wyoming, registeredagent.net. So really cool service, guys. They basically can incorporate you in the state of Wyoming. Now, again, I'm not legally telling you to do this. You can incorporate anywhere you want, your own state, whatever. I just chose Wyoming after I did some research and found out that the three most like business friendly ones, it was like Nevada, Delaware, and Wyoming. And I just preferred Wyoming. I thought that was the most business friendly for what I needed. And these guys have been reputable. They've done nothing but right by me and my members. And you can see here that they charge to form an LLC or corporation just $149. You guys know what it cost me in Texas. If I did it by myself, it would cost me $300. If I used LegalZoom, it would cost me $600. If I hired an attorney, it might cost me $1,000 to $2,000. But again, do what you need to do. I am not giving you legal advice, guys. So, they can even do mail forwarding. So they can even take your mail and you can use their address as your address. And you can basically they'll forward it to wherever you are anywhere in the world. So if you get a mail there, they'll forward it to you. And yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. That's honestly all you have to do. Another resource obviously is LegalZoom.com. I have not used them before ever because I'm not willing to pay them to do it. But one quick advice, guys, one quick advice that a friend told me about that I started using is upcounsel.com. Now, this is pretty legit. I've actually found attorneys on upcounsel.com to do a lot of things for my company, like form the terms of conditions, create partnerships agreement. You can find an attorney like you can find a freelancer, and you can base it on your city. You can base it on the type of work you need, contracts, legal, da da da. But this is really, really legit, guys. I strongly recommend it for you. Upcounsel.com. Again, I'm not affiliated with them. I don't get any commission with them. It's just services I've used before. And I actually prefer them over LegalZoom because with Upcounsel, you actually get to work directly with your attorney. So you get to pick. They actually, basically, the attorney fights for your business. That's so crazy. So, anyways, that's how I would recommend doing all that. Now, you can also, if you're not in the United States, and you're not able to form a US business address or US bank account, you can get your attorney, like some sort of temporary power of attorney, to set up a bank account for you if you know no one else. And honestly, I prefer to do that over like trusting a family member or something. So there you go, guys. Hope you enjoy that. That's the three things you need before you move forward. I'll see you in the next lesson where I'm going to tell you what you need in terms of what bank accounts, not bank accounts, I'm sorry, what accounts you need to start setting up now before you go on to phase two. Okay, there's going to be some things you're going to have to get set up and started. I'll see you guys in the next lesson. If you found this helpful, guys, comment below Or, you know, shoot me an email and just say, hey, AJ, thank you so much. I really appreciate it, the legal part, because that gives me some good feedback on what I need to improve on in my training moving forward. Thank you, guys. See you in the next lesson.